Hi, everybody. Are you having a good summer? I am. I was sitting home by my pool and I was thinking, what would make this summer complete? Maybe a Tom Cruise show rerun. I don't know if you've heard, but I enjoy Tom Cruise. I know that everyone thinks the first time I met him was here in my show, but it's actually not true. First time I met him was at the premiere of Malice, Nicole Kidman's movie in L.A. And I was really nervous. I was there with Emilio Estevez, and my palms were sweaty. And Emilio knew that I had a crush on Tom for years. So Emilio said, come here, let me meet Tom. And I was nervous because Nicole was there, and I met him. And I didn't know that anyone took a picture, but some fan person got a picture and then knew and sent it to me. So look, this is actually, that's me. Right there, like give me the, take this one, take a real one. There, see this? This is me, I swear. Look, it's like, see that's my nose? It's when I had long hair, look. And that's Tommy, and that's, I don't know who that is. That's
somebody.
I don't know who it is. It's some model or something, I'm not sure. But this is me, as I said, and that's Tommy. And if you notice, get closer, please, get closer. This person is very connected to this person. Look, look at the contact of the eyes and the gaze. And look at this stranger again, sort of gazing off over there. So obviously.
You're kind of wearing the same thing, too.
Yeah. Yeah. Wrote a little song about Tom during the summer. Thought you might want to hear it. Why do tears and butterflies come each time I watch Top Gun? My Tommy, I long to be close to you. When you take Dustin Hoffman's hand, I pretend I'm Rain Man. My Tommy, why ain't it me close to you? On the day you met Nicole, it really screwed my karma. Now all I sing's the other woman blues. But I dream of when you'll do yard work and I'll be known as Mrs. Tommy Cruise. That is why the bridal shop in town keeps mothballs with my gown. My Tommy, I long to be close to you. My Tommy, I long to be close to you.
Nice.
Play the Tommy Show!
Hi, I'm Isaac Patinkin from New York City, New York, and this is the Rosie O'Donnell Show. Today's guests are Cuba Gooding Jr., Renee Zellweger, and Tom Cruise. Hit it, John! Movies, yeah, she can do it.
I am. I was back there thinking it will be so horrible if I get sick before the show. I'm breathing deep, and I had a lot of Altoids. Isaac, excellent job with the announce.
Thank you.
How you doing, Isaac?
I'm okay.
You know who Isaac's dad is? Tell everybody, Isaac.
Mandy Patinkin.
Mandy Patinkin, we love. We love. Now, Isaac, aside from Mandy, who is your favorite actor?
You.
Oh, no, no. That's nice. I mean guy actor.
Guy actor?
Yeah.
It can't be a girl?
No.
Tom Cruise.
Tom Cruise, yeah! Who are you here with, Isaac?
I'm here with my friend Jeremiah.
Hi, Jeremiah, how are you?
Good, how are you?
Good, just curious, who's your favorite actor?
Tom Cruise.
Tom Cruise, all right, it's going around. It's going around. You guys did a great job, thanks for being here. I will now try to take in more air. Strength to the limbs, and I'll walk to my desk. Say hello to John McD and the McDLP.
I'm okay, how are you?
I'm a little scared.
Holding it together?
I'm okay, I'm all
right.
My sister's here.
Yeah.
And my sister was in his dressing room for 20 minutes.
You're kidding.
I didn't want to go say hello to him because I want to see him out here. I don't want to see him out there and then ruin it. You know, I want to wait. Look at this, is because my palms are sweaty. And I'm like, where's my sister? Where's my sister? And the stage manager said, oh, she's been in Tom's dressing room for 20 minutes.
Wow.
Today on Sally Jesse Raphael. Maureen O'Donnell stealing her sister's love.
That's right. Oh my gosh. Incredible.
If Scott Wolf was here, your little boyfriend, I wouldn't hug him! Okay, Tom's here.
Yep, he'll be out.
Also, the pretty girl who plays his girlfriend, whatever. And, Cuba Gooding Jr. You guys saw the movie, didn't you like it? Did I tell you? It's a great movie. My hands are a little shaky. Can you see it? They're a little shaky? Just a little. Look. It's like I had too much sugar or something. But I didn't. And it was good reason that my hands were shaking, because soon you'll see. Tommy and I hit it off quite delightfully. Let's just say he couldn't stop kissing me, okay? Whatever. Set the VCRs, the Rosie and Tommy smooch. Coming up, just a few. Just so you people at home know, my sister is now taunting me from the audience, going like this. During the commercials, which is so mean to do to me, your best friend. Our first guest is a talented young actor. We all know him from Boys in the Hood and Outbreak. He stars in a new movie called Jerry Maguire with, oh, what do you know? My friend Tommy. Take a look.
Yeah, no. Show you the money.
That's not so good. Show me the money.
Show me the money.
Yes. Louder.
Show me the money.
Yes, sir, brother, but you got to yell at.
Show me the money!
I need to feel you, Jerry!
Show me the money!
Jerry, you better yell! Show me the money! Show me the money! You're the loudest black man! Show me the money! I love black people!
I love black people!
What you gonna do, Jerry?
Show me the money!
Congratulations, you're still my agent.
Please welcome Cuba Gooding Jr. This movie.
Oh, thank you. You are
really great in the movie. I absolutely loved your performance. Did you have a good time shooting it?
Oh, it was amazing. It was an amazing, amazing experience. Every aspect of it, you know?
Yeah. Tom.
Tom. Yeah. Just being that close to Tom.
Was good
just,
for you, too. You it's know, good for everyone. Don't feel weird about it. I feel a little faint.
Just
yeah, think, sure. You worked with him before.
Yes, I did. In A Few Good Men.
Yeah, A Few Good Men.
Yeah.
So it's your second Tom.
That's
movie.
Right. Yeah. It's the second time.
Did he ever mention me? Just curious.
Yeah, you know.
He did?
That's so funny you brought that up.
What?
You know, we were on the set and Jack said something like, I think you messed your line up. And he said, no, Rosie gave me advice on that and just inspiration in her performances that she does. I have to change that line. And Jack said, you know, I love Rosie. He said, you love Rosie too? They both had a little Rosie
wow,
O'Donnell.
Wow, I had no idea that. Yeah. That's amazing. Yeah. Yeah.
I got a little love for you, madam.
You do?
So.
Yes. Got the Kwan going on.
That's
there
right.
you go. So you must be getting millions of offers to do movies. You're in so many things. You're doing so great.
Yeah, it's been kind of cool.
You were up for the role in Basquiat, I heard.
Oh, wow. Yeah, this I don't know if you guys know, Jean-Michel Basquiat was a painter, a black painter who was kind of weirded out like Andy Warhol. I mean, he did body art where he'd get, you know, he'd like urinate on canvases and all kinds of freaky stuff. But it was a really great, interesting.
That's art.
Yeah. Yes, that's
art. And it was a great movie, actually. David Bowie was in it.
Yeah, and it came out. But that was an audition that I never got, I always wanted. And the director wouldn't see me because he had known Basquiat personally, and he thought I didn't look like him and I couldn't pull off the role. So what I did is I found out where the office was, and I got a bucket of purple paint.
Yeah.
And I went down there in only my underwear and snow boots and a handful of dead roses and a canvas. And I walked into the casting director's office and she saw me standing there and she said, oh my. And I threw the canvas down and poured the paint over myself and writhed on the floor. I was like, Basquiat lives.
Oh no.
And a buddy of mine was taping it and handed it at the tape and said, you know, nobody has the role, da da da. And of course I didn't do the movie, so I guess that was.
But guess what, Cuba?
Yeah.
We got that tape. No, we don't, we don't.
All right, Rosie, nice seeing you. Great. Oh. It's been fun.
So you grew up in the desert, huh?
Yeah. I played Apple Valley High School and Apple Valley Junior High School. And
you used to pull weeds for a living?
Yeah, well, yeah.
How could that be? What do you mean by that?
Well, you know, in the middle of the desert, there's nothing but weeds. No tumbleweed action. That's about it.
Yeah.
And I was too young to get, like, a normal job. I was, like, 13 or whatever, And I would go door to door to people's houses and say, you know, lovely yard, but all these weeds, you know, I pull them for $10 and then like, okay. And, you know, spend the day pulling weeds and do that.
You Where know, do you live now? You live in L.A.?
Yeah, in Studio City.
And you just had a new baby?
Yes.
Two boys now. You have two boys.
Thank you.
It's the greatest.
Yes, it is.
How old is your new one?
My new one was November 14th, so he's like really
brand
new.
Yeah,
a couple of weeks. And I have a 2-year-old boy, so you got the terrible twos and the newborn. And I also have 3 Great Danes, you know, and the house is like kind of crazy now.
3 Great Danes? Are you scared with the baby and the big dogs? Or?
No, when we first brought the 2-year-old home the first time, so the first baby, I was a little nervous.
Yeah.
And I'd follow him around and, you know, dogs sniff everything, you know, and they'd be sniffing them. I'd be like, break your neck.
Right.
But they were cool. They're really cool.
You know what the hottest toy is this Christmas? Tickle Me Elmo.
Yes.
It's very hard to get, but look what we got for you.
Oh.
We got for your two babies, 2 Tickle Me Elmos for Christmas.
Goodness.
For coming and doing
this show
when you're so tired from your press junket.
My son loves Elmo.
See, they'll love them.
He loves Elmo.
I know you're going to get nominated for this movie. I really do think you're going to get a nomination, Best Supporting Actor. When you do, you'll come back, all right?
Yeah.
Cuba Gooding Jr., thank you for being here.
You're welcome.
Second, that the fact that our next guest co-stars with my Tommy in his new movie, Jerry Maguire, and gets to kiss him and do a love scene with him bothers me in the least bit. No, not at all. Really, honest, I swear. Please welcome Renee Zellweger.
Hi, it's okay.
No, it's I don't have any bitterness. I like Nicole. I can learn to like you.
I appreciate that. Yeah, I like her too. I learned to like her too. You know
yeah.
What I mean?
You did great in the movie.
Thank you.
You really did.
Thank you.
How scared were you when they told you you were going to be Tom Cruise's love interest in a film?
Yeah, pretty scared.
You were?
About as scared as when I just took that walk down the hall that made Rosie O'Donnell.
Oh, no. Don't even. You couldn't have been.
Not even kidding.
You were nervous because you thought I'd be mean to you because I got a little crush on Tom. Did you hear I have a little crush on you?
Somebody said something about that.
Yeah, yeah, a little crush. Yeah. So you went into the audition. Was he there?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
What happened? He's so nice.
He's nice.
You
I know. I
met
him.
He's so neat. He sits there in a little chair and he's like a little glowy boy. Yeah. He has this little halo around him, this white light, and he shakes your hand and you go, God, you're good looking.
And he is.
Yeah, you know. You noticed too.
Right,
huh?
Like a couple times, picked it up occasionally. Also, I was curious as to, you had a few kissing scenes with him.
Here comes, huh?
I was just curious as to whether or not you enjoyed them.
Well, can I just say, like, just for the record, we were not alone. Mm-hmm. There were hundreds of people around, uh-huh, chaperoning the entire thing.
Yeah,
promise.
Right. Did he keep his jeans on during that love scene?
I tried, but yeah, he did.
He did? He kept his jeans on underneath the covers? Yeah. I knew it. I turned to my friends and said, my Tommy would not be naked in this scene. Some other actors, some other scummy actors, I won't say names, they would have been naked, but not my Tommy. Was I right? You're great in the movie. We have a clip. We have 'kay. A clip. Do you know what clip we have?
No, actually, I don't know.
Really? Well, it'll be you. And Tom Cruise, so maybe you might want to watch it. From Jerry Maguire, Renee Zellweger, my friend. Take a look.
I'm so glad you're home. You know, I just, that loan thing, it's not my specialty.
Oh, my God.
Oh, yeah, oh, my God. Well, I broke up with Avery.
Gosh, you know, that's too bad.
No, it's better because we're still going to be friends and, you know, it's better now than later.
Sure.
You know, I mean, I'm dying here, aren't I?
Yeah, it's a really bad cut.
Yeah, well, just think if I got her the ring she really wanted.
You're good in that.
Thanks.
Now, I went to see a movie in the movie theater and I saw you in a trailer for another movie.
Mm. Yeah,
like,
uh-huh.
It's sort of like in the Old West. What movie is that? Or like, it's like in the olden days?
Yeah, the 30s in
Texas. That was in one,
yeah.
30s. In Texas?
Hawaii World.
I was right. And who's in it with you?
Vincent D'Onofrio.
And what's it called?
Hawaii World.
Hawaii World?
The whole...
Oh, the whole wide world. Maybe you should put the gum back in. No, because he gets saliva when you're nervous. The whole wide world, what's it about?
It's a true story, actually, about a school teacher in Texas named Novelyn Price who befriends the writer Robert E. Howard,
yeah,
who did the Conan, the Barbarian stuff, you know?
And you're a writer, yeah, and he's a writer. It,
yeah,
looks really good.
Yeah.
Are you getting a lot of movie roles now?
I don't know. I've been kind of away.
Where you been?
I went up to Big Bear, and I went home to Texas for a while, and to the Amazon.
You went to the Amazon?
Yeah.
What were you doing,
yeah,
there? Press junket?
Yeah.
No. What were you doing there?
Actually, rowing a boat and looking at caimans and getting bitten by all kinds of interesting bugs and stuff.
You just went like on vacation?
Yeah, actually went down for the whole wide world to the Argentine Film Festival, and I decided that you can't just stay at the great hotels and eat the great restaurants and that be South America. You know, that's,
yeah,
just not the experience. So we headed into the jungle and rode some boats and hiked some hills and it was awesome.
Did you see any live animals?
Several.
Any scary ones?
Several.
Like?
Some pretty wild monkeys in the trees and some jaguars in the distance and stuff.
Really?
Yeah.
Were you scared?
She's getting all these ideas.
Renee, I have nothing but admiration for you. I don't know why you're thinking these things. If you feel residual guilt about making out with my boyfriend in a movie, there's nothing I can do about it, Renee. No, I think you're great. You're great in the movie, and
thank
you're a great
you.
Young actress. You're very young. How old are you? Do you mind if I ask you
27.
That? You're 27. Uh-huh. You're just a little kid. You look a little bit like Jewel. Did anyone ever tell you that?
Yesterday, actually.
The singer Jewel.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's a good
yeah.
thing.
Yeah, I was thinking so.
Yeah.
My friends are laughing up there because...
All right. I don't know where they are, but hi. Hi, the friends of Renee. My boyfriend. She kissed. Anyway, but you're great. The movie's Jerry Maguire, of course, and it's really nice to meet you.
It's nice to meet you, too.
Come back for your next movie, The Whole Wide World. Don't go anywhere. Shake my
oh,
hand.
Yeah.
All right, there you go. We'll be right back with Tom Cruise.
This is the moment. Oh, my man, I love him. Tom Cruise. This is the moment. Tom Cruise. This is Tom Cruise.
This is Tom Cruise. I lost my mind! Tom Cruise right after this. I don't know if you know it, but my boyfriend is right around that corner. He's my one and only. I love him. Please welcome the most perfect man on the planet, my Tommy, Tom Cruise!
So do you.
Thank you.
I'm nervous.
You're nervous?
I'm nervous.
Don't be nervous. You're my Tommy. Tom, I don't know if you've been watching the show.
Yes.
I got a little crush on you. You don't mind it, do you?
No.
No. Does it scare you a little bit? Am I like an inch away from being a stalker? Because I fear that I may frighten your entire family.
No, no.
No, it's all right.
They love it.
It's all right.
Yeah.
Nicole's all right with it, too.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
She knows.
Absolutely, absolutely.
You know, it's not like I want the marriage to break up to me. I just want you to, like, live in my house and mow my lawn. That's all I want. I want you to do yard work around my house. Have you ever been, like, infatuated with anyone? Truly? Is it?
Oh, sure, yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
How was it? Was it like, no, not somebody like that you actually...
That I married?
Oh, like Nicole, of course.
Yeah, yeah.
Because you saw her in Dead Calm, right?
Yes.
And you thought, I like her.
Yeah, I thought she's very talented.
Yeah, she is talented. The new movie's supposed to be great.
Yeah, she's extraordinary.
She's coming on this show.
I know, she's looking
forward to it. Just a couple days,
it.
Yeah. No, I like her, I do, it's okay. It's Renee I was upset with. It's Renee in the movie with all that kissing with you. Tom, I didn't like that. But I love the movie. It's a great movie. The whole audience loved it.
Thank you.
Did you have fun making it?
Yes, I did.
You did?
I did.
You had a good time?
Had a very good time. Yeah.
Cuba Gooding, he was great. Very
awesome.
Funny in
awesome.
The movie.
Yeah.
Your family goes on location with you when you go, right?
Yes, everywhere.
Good. That's
everywhere.
Good. Because you got to keep the family together.
Got to keep the family together.
And how are your kids? You got two kids?
They're doing great. They're probably taking a nap right now. I put my son down right before I got here.
Really?
Yeah, no, they got all the cousins and everything they're playing with right now.
Yeah, what are you doing for the holidays? Do you have to work?
No, we're going to take a couple of weeks. I don't know where we're going to go, but we're going to rest because we've been working pretty hard.
Yeah.
Yeah, I came in just for your show.
You did?
Yeah, yep. Shooting, and I came in from London.
Yeah?
I came in from London to do your show.
Yeah, that's good. You have a good time there, right? Barbara Walters told me that you might live there. Is that true?
I don't know really where we're going to end up. Nick's Australian, and we're just, you know, when you're actors, you kind of, you know what it's like. You're traveling around all the time. And
go everywhere.
Yeah, we'll figure it out. I'm not Not sure yet.
Yeah, yeah. Just let me know. No, because, you know, I could relocate.
I won't leave the country.
All right, good. Don't leave the country without telling me.
No, I won't.
Because, you know, your sister's restaurant? Your sister has a restaurant?
Yes, yes.
Which sister is that?
My little sister,
yeah,
Cass.
People send me food from her restaurant.
How do you like it?
It's great. The spare ribs from Cass's restaurant are really good.
She's a very good cook.
And how's your mom doing?
I was lucky. I have three girls, sisters, and they took care of me when I was growing up.
Yeah, you're very close to your whole family.
Yeah, yeah. I've got two of them actually here, my mother's.
Your mom's here?
Yeah, yeah. It's definitely,
gotta go say hello to her. We're like this. We met, remember? We met at your tribute when you were honored.
Maureen met the whole family. Sorry about that.
She asked me if she could come. I said yes. I had no idea where she was. She was annoying you for 20 minutes, my sister?
No, she's very charming.
She was charming?
Yes.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Interesting. My sister is married. Just for the record, for everyone out there. Now, we went and tried to pull all of our favorite clips from all your movies, and there were too many even to pull, you know? Because I have all your movies. I have them on LaserDisc.
Really?
I have Cocktail on LaserDisc.
Okay.
I have Far and Away. And I have Top Gun, of course. And I'm hoping to get Jerry Maguire soon.
You'll get it.
We have a clip of you, Jerry Maguire. I understand you picked this clip special.
Yes. Which one is it?
I'm not sure, but they just told me that's the one you wanted me to see.
Okay, well, let's see it now.
Want to see it?
There's, yes.
All right, let's roll the clip from Jerry Maguire. Tom.
Well, this... be good night.
Good night.
I'll see you tomorrow.
I'll see you tomorrow.
Yeah, good day.
Mm-hmm.
See, she's like that.
Well, good night.
Good night. Oops.
The good clip. The good clip. I don't know that it was my favorite clip of the film, Tom, but it's a very good clip. The little boy in the movie, what's his name?
Jonathan Lipnicki.
What a wonderful little actor he is.
Yeah.
How old is he?
Well, I think he's 5 years old now, 6 years old.
Yeah, he was great.
We called him El Fuego.
Oh, yeah?
El Fuego, because he... kid would show up, he's just on fire, you know, when we were working together.
Did he make up some of the lines? Because they didn't seem like they were scripted.
No, actually, we just keep the camera rolling, and sometimes Cameron would just give him the lines off camera, and we'd just talk together and work until we got the scene, and he was very relaxed, and he'd seen Top Gun a few times, and so he'd always show up on the set, and when he was ready to go, he'd say, I feel the need for speed. High five him, and we all go, El Fuego!
How cute is that?
He's sweet.
Would you mind staying for a couple more segments?
Sure.
Oh, all right.
Yeah,
we'll be right back after this commercial.
Didn't he? Because that's what you told Lieutenant Kendrick to do.
Object!
And when it went bad, you cut these guys loose!
Your Honor,
you had Marcus inside a phony transport!
Your Honor,
you doctored the logbook!
Damn it, Captain!
You coerced the doctor!
Consider yourself in contempt!
Colonel Jessup, did you order the code red?
You don't have to answer that question.
I'll answer the question. You want answers?
I think I'm entitled to.
You want answers?
I want the truth!
You can't handle the truth!
That's a great movie. You good man. Were you nervous to work with him?
I started out, yeah.
Jack Nicholson.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
We shot that the first 3 weeks into it.
You shot that scene the first three
weeks? First 3 weeks into it. But yeah, I was nervous. And but he was, when we started working on the scene, it was just,
he put you at ease.
put me at ease, rock and roll, you know, working with Rob. It was a very well-written scene, so I was looking forward to doing
what
it.
What actors did you like when you were growing up? Who did you like idolize?
You know, certainly Hoffman, Newman, Nicholson, you know, De Niro.
You worked with all of them.
Pacino, Duvall, a brilliant actor. And I liked Spencer Tracy. And
were you a real, like, movie-going kid? Were you a big fan of entertainment?
Loved it.
Did you ever want to do anything else when you were little? Did you know you'd be an actor?
I didn't know. I wanted to be an astronaut.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I wanted to be an astronaut, wanted to be a pilot. And I never thought that I could ever have anything to do with this when I was growing up. I thought this was just, you know, other people got to do this. I didn't know it would ever happen to me. I just loved movies, and I never thought this would happen to me.
And you are a pilot now, aren't you?
Yes.
And it makes me a little nervous, Tom. You fly your own little plane.
Fly my own little aerobatic
plane. And at your benefit, they were telling me that it's this plane that's really hard to control.
Yes.
Now, what's that? Is it a special little plane?
Yeah, it's called a Pitts. And I have a couple of aerobatic airplanes. And this is a, you know, it's a tricky little beautiful airplane. But, you know, an aerobatic airplane has to be unstable because you want to put it in all these different kinds of attitudes. And it's a great airplane.
Does it ever scare you?
No, not yet. Not yet.
Have you ever had any dangerous mishaps in it?
Truthfully? Not really.
No,
you haven't. Not really.
When you
not
do a
really.
Movie, do they say you're not allowed to do anything dangerous during the filming?
I'm not allowed to fly aerobatics during it, but I fly airplanes anyway when I'm doing it. I've got a twin-engine airplane that I fly, and so I'm allowed to fly that, but I'm not allowed to put it into a dive or anything. Or
yeah.
Inverted flight. No, they
I'm trying to get
that
law passed in Congress that you're not allowed to do that. Because I don't want you to be injured, my little Tommy. Now, also, you do this auto racing. What is that? You got with Paul Newman, The Days of Thunder, also owned on Laserdisc. That film, you got into car racing, right?
Yeah. Yeah. He was very interested in it, and I liked driving, and he said, you know, took me out and drove me around and said, you should try this. And I raced for his team for two seasons, and I still race against Newman. He's amazing. Just when you think you can get this guy, you know, he passes you. He's unbelievable. Unbelievable race car driver.
Is there still anyone you're really dying to work with?
Yeah, I mean, I'd like to have a chance to work with all those guys again. There's a lot of people. A lot of people I'd like to work with.
What was your favorite role? Favorite movie role?
I love playing Jerry Maguire.
Yeah.
You know, I know it's coming out now, but it was a great character, you know, very. To be able to have that level of humor and physical comedy, and you're exceptional at, and I haven't. Yeah, you are.
Well,
you are.
I can only do one thing. You do many things.
And the drama, it was very challenging, a lot of fun.
You know, and it leaves you feeling good. It's such a feel-good movie. You have hope at the end of it. You get all tingly. Did you get all tingly? Because I'm tingly now. Come to think of it, I'm a little tingly right now.
Good.
And it opens on Friday the 13th.
I know.
Right, December 13th.
Well, Cuba said that's his lucky day.
It is.
Cuba Gooding said it's his lucky day, so I said, okay, well, let's, you know, Friday the 13th it is, so.
I'm sure it's going to be a huge hit.
Well, you know, you never know, but I'm proud of the film.
Yeah, you should be.
Yeah.
We all loved
Thank you.
It. And don't
Thank
go
you.
Anywhere, because we have you. To do another commercial.
Oh, commercial, okay.
Yeah, don't go anywhere.
No, I won't go anywhere. I'm here.
Because you know what I have?
What do you have?
I have this photo booth over there. And
I saw that.
Yeah, I thought maybe, you know.
We could get in there. And
yeah, we could get in there.
Absolutely.
Just take some pictures, that's all.
Good.
All right. Tom Cruise will be here still, so don't go anywhere.
I'll never forget the meeting.
Yeah. Back with Tom Cruise, my boyfriend. That was Risky Business. How old were you when you did that? Do you remember?
I was 19 years old.
19 years
yeah.
old.
Yeah.
And they told you had to be in your underwear. Did you get nervous or no?
No.
You didn't?
No.
No.
No, I wasn't.
Yeah. Oh. That was a good movie.
Thanks.
Yeah, I like that movie. That was pretty much the first one that made you really well known. You were in Taps, I know, Harold Becker.
Yeah, I was
Becker.
In Taps with Harold Becker.
Yes, yeah. He's my friend.
Yeah, he's my friend also.
Every time we have dinner, Harold and his wife Susan, Harold says to me, I discovered Tom Cruise. I discovered Tom Cruise.
You did.
You buy dinner. That's what he said. It makes
you
me,
buy dinner.
Yeah, because he discovered Tom Cruise. I have to buy the dinner. You know, I usually do. What the heck? It's worth it. But you've had so many successes. And any of them ones that you thought would do really well surprise you that, you know, went out of this world? Or at some of them that you expected to do well didn't do as well?
No, I really don't know what's going to do well when I'm making it or what's not. But, I mean, yeah, it surprises you when they make that kind of money. When they're so big, you're always a little like, my God.
Yeah.
And, but I really don't know how a picture's going to do. I always kind of hope, I hope the studio makes their money back and some change so I can, you know, keep doing this for a little bit or let me do what I want to do right now, so.
Do you get sick of all the adoration by people like me? I mean, does it get hard for you? You probably can't walk anywhere. I mean,
no, we go places. When I'm going to promote a film, there's usually a lot more attention. But we go around and walk
people
the street and do
no.
that.
No, women
people
don't
say,
like throw underwear at you and scream, "Oh my God, it's Tom! Oh my God, it's Tom! Oh my God, it's Tom!" or something. No. No.
Not
really.
No.
Sorry.
No.
Okay. I didn't want to scare you.
No.
All right.
No. There's some. You know. I mean. Yeah. There's stuff that happens, but you just kind of go, okay. And but it's not. You know. Really, people are very generous and nice and want it on. They just usually just want to say hello or something.
Does Nicole get angry? Because a lot of girls, you know, like you. Do people like? I'm sure that she's there and they walk right past her.
No, she's very understanding.
She is. Yeah.
She's very relaxed.
Well, she ain't too bad to look at herself. That Nicole Kidman.
Yeah, yeah.
Probably a lot of guys going over you, going get away. Now, Cuba told me that you guys played in some hockey league and that some guys tried to hurt you because you were Tom Cruise or something.
He would go on and he'd say, I'd say, look, I haven't played in years. He says, don't worry, I'll take care of you. And I'll never forget, at the end of the first day, first night we're playing hockey, and I see Cuba over some guy, you know, ready to get in a fight. And I said, he had to shoot the next day. I said, oh my God, don't hit him, you know?
But they tried to, like, body block you and everything because they thought, oh, Tom Cruise, I'm going to take him out, right?
Yeah, they you know, a couple of the guys took some shots, but they were pretty cool about it.
They were all right.
Yeah.
Because I got their names and numbers.
Did you? Cuba gave it to you.
Yeah, Cuba.
No, Cuba took care of me on the ice.
He did,
you know? No one wants
he
to mess with
you.
Cuba.
You're very athletic. You love to do all sorts of sports.
And, yeah, I like sports.
Yeah.
Doing all different kinds of things.
Dangerous stuff like we
said. Yeah, like, you know, hockey and football and flying airplanes and skydiving and race cars and
watching shows on TV in the afternoon. At some point, it like borders on sick, doesn't it? You know, I know that you're just a guy, you've got a wife and a family, and you're just a guy who's an actor, but somehow, you make me really happy. You do! Tom's new movie, as we mentioned, is called Jerry Maguire. And we'll talk a little bit more about that in this next segment. And we're also going to go into the photo booth with Tom. And the photos will be shown when your wife's here. Just in a nice, friendly kind of way, as a gift. I'm presenting them as a peace offering. But Nicole and I are like this, right?
Yes.
Yeah, we're good
yes,
friends.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Whatever. And no. We'll have more with my Tommy after this break.
Successful film I've ever made.
That's your most successful film.
Yeah,
and You also produced it.
Yes.
It's your first movie that you produced.
First film with my partner, Paula Wagner, and my company,
Are you going to produce more?
Yeah, we've got another film that we just produced that I'm not in called Pre, that Bob Town directed. His terrific actor, Billy Crudup and Donald Sutherland. And
Pre, what does that stand for?
Stands for Prefontaine. He's one of the greatest American runners we've ever had, and it's a great story.
And do you want to direct, do you think?
Yeah, you know, one day I'll try. I've been offered a few things to direct, but I'm, you know, I've just got to wait for the right piece that I want to do. It's very demanding. It's demanding. You know, it takes months to prep a film for me as an actor, but as a director, it's, you know, it's a 2-year commitment most of the time. So, and it's a lot.
Yeah, from start to finish.
Yeah, so it really has to be, you know, the right thing, and I haven't been able to find it yet.
Do you think you would want to be in a movie you direct, or would that be too hard?
I don't know. You know, I admire those actors that went out and directed themselves. I don't know how good I'd be at directing myself, because I depend heavily on that relationship with the director, and it feeds me, and I get a lot of ideas, because when I act, I don't really think about what I'm doing, so I don't know how objective. I'm pretty good. There's certain blind spots I have with my performance that, you know, when I'm looking at rushes or editing, that I kind of say to the director, okay, you know, but we'll see. I really don't know.
Do you go to the rushes? And when you shoot a film, you can see the day before's work at a little screening room. Mostly the director does it. A lot of actors don't go. I don't like to go because I get self-conscious. But do you go watch yourself?
No, I like to go. I like to see what the director's, you know, doing, how they're shooting it. And it just it helps me to understand their vision of the picture more. And I think that I can help the director better if I see it. And they like it because I'm not interfering or anything. I just, you know, it really helps me to help the movie, you know.
Is
help
one...
me help you, you know.
Show me the money! You know? Is there one performance you're most proud of? I would guess it would be Born on the 4th of July, but I don't know.
No.
No? I
am very proud of it, but it's I don't know if there's one that I'm very proud of that performance and proud of that I made that film, and I feel really, you know, it's hard for me to look back and to pick just one, because I give so much to everything. I'm really proud of the performance in Jerry Maguire. For me, it was a very challenging role, so I'm happy with that.
And it opens December 13th.
Friday the 13th.
Yes, and your wife, Nicole, has a new movie, Portrait of a Lady.
Portrait of a Lady,
and that opens
stunning.
What day?
Yeah, that opens December 25th.
December 25th, so we'll give Nicole Kidman, great actress, a little plug too. You know, whatever. And, you know, I just want to say something, that it's been really great having you here, and a lot of people would not have showed up after all the stuff that I did. Because, you know, it's like an inch away from a stalker. You know what I mean? I'm just a moment away from being totally insane and living outside your house in a sleeping bag. But I was just wondering if you might possibly like to go have a little photo.
Let's do it.
As we leave, and there's a little camera
in
there. A little Tommy. The camera in here. All right, come on, squish over. See, the camera's there. Hi, right in there.
Let's go.
Here's the camera, me and Tom. Hi, everybody. I just want to say, dreams come true on the Rosie O'Donnell Show with my boyfriend, Tom Cruise, in a photo booth on prom weekend. Oh. You're the best. Thank you for being here. Do come true when you wish upon a star like my Tom Cruise. On tomorrow's show, Kathy Lee Gifford, Neil Diamond, and Laura Dern. Don't miss it. Thank you, Tom. I love you. Bye!